So one other concept with atrial fibrillation ablation is that it is independent of giving it 3 months. You really have to hope that every spot we address, which ultimately is sometimes 100 different little spots, all those spots have to heal well. And so when I really, one of the single biggest pieces of advice I can give patients is I really think you need to judge success of these procedures as one or two procedures. A reasonable minority of patients need a second procedure to achieve a long-term cure. The challenge is we really don't have a great sense of predicting who that's going to be. We give everybody the same provocative challenge at the end of the procedure, and it's really how well do those lesions heal. The concept I try to say is these tissue in retrospect is probably wounded and it wasn't a pure scar. That's why there's often a second procedure necessary. But when you think about catheter ablation, I think you need to judge it as a one or two procedure and not just say I'm going to do one procedure then I'm done, because I've seen patients where we go back in a second time and it's literally a single spot. And so 60-second ablation is all they need. They never have another heart blip. But if they had not done that, they would have had a real challenging time. And so it's kind of humbling because you can do 99% of it really well the first time and still have to go back in for that consolidation procedure after 3 months. You know, one of the things I try to educate my patients, I do think the safety of these procedures is very, very, very appropriate for widespread implementation. There are trivial risks with any procedure. There's certain unique risks to this procedure, but ultimately the safety profile I think is appropriate for an 18-year-old all the way up to an 80-year-old and even beyond. So I don't think there's an age cutoff if the health is otherwise good that says, you know, you reach a threshold, you can't have this performed. With that being said, if you have a bunch of comorbid conditions, the success rate of atrial fibrillation ablation is probably lower, but ultimately a healthy 82-year-old with AFib is really their only challenge. We routinely perform ablations of them with some careful deliberation of a risk-benefit analysis. What I tell patients is we have had patients that go back to work the next day. I mean, ultimately, other than taking it easy on the groin from the standpoint of low impact activities, we don't want you running a marathon or doing squats, but ultimately, other than that, you can oftentimes get back to all your activities quite quickly. One of the very rare non-life-threatening but worth mentioning complications is a 1-2% chance you'll get a little bump or a bruise in the groin. That can be a nuisance. It frankly can occur right away or can occur a day or two later, but that's really the only thing I would expect. When patients leave the hospital with 99.8% assuredness, all of the major risks of the procedure are behind them, and really the likelihood of them having any trouble moving forward is very low. You know, we're happy to say that well over 99% of our patients go home the day after the procedure. It's very rare a patient needs to stay for more than one night. One night stay is our standard of care, but the vast majority, north of 99%, go home on that first day after the procedure.